Turba Charger nedir diye sordunuz ve İtalya'da Turba Charger'ın kitabını yazmış adamı bulduk. Samato'dan Luca ile birlikteyiz. Luca benim master'dan sınıf arkadaşım. İlk seneden sonra kendisi powertrain üstüne okumaya devam etti. Ve sonrasında babasının yanına gelerek burada araçlar üstünde çalışmaya başladı. Ve bugün kendisiyle birlikte Turbo Charger üstünde konuşacağız. Instagram üstünden birçok soru aldık. Bunları da Luca'ya soracağım ve kendisi bize her şeyi açıklayacak. So Luca, ciao.
Good morning, Gus. Gus,
how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
I'm fine too, thank you.
Welcome to our company. For me, it's a pleasure to be here today with you. Especially because we were colleagues at the university.
And after 2 years, finally, we are recording a video. So, let's start with turbochargers. What is a turbocharger?
A turbocharger is a machine which uses the exhaust gases which passes through the turbine of the turbocharger, spinning the turbocharger wheels. And through a shaft connected to the compressor wheel, forces more air into the engine in a way that if we have more air delivered to the engine, we can increase the amount of fuel injected in the combustion chamber, increasing the power output of the engine. So the main target of turbocharging system device is to increase engine power.
So we see a turbocharger here, maybe we can show the components on it.
Yes. The turbocharger has three main components, which are the turbine, the compressor, and the center housing or rotating assembly, which is also named Core AC. The turbine is the part of the turbocharger where the exhaust gases expand, and this gas expansion is used by the turbine wheel to spin up compressor wheel. Exhaust gases flow, enter radially and exit axially. So it's a centripetal machine, whereas the compressor on the other side is a centrifugal machine, because the inlet air enters in the compressor axially and exit radially up to the intake system. So we can have also an intercooler between the compressor and intake manifold or not. The center part of the turbocharger is the Core AC. In this center housing we have a shaft which connects the compressor and the turbine. This shaft has two wheels on the extremities, which are the turbine wheel and the compressor wheel. They rotate connected to the same shaft, so when in an equilibrium condition we have that the wheels are spinning at the same velocity, because they are mechanically connected on the same shaft. In the center housing we have also the cooling system of the turbocharger, which is made by the coolant from the engine and also from the oil from the engine. So the oil has two functions, the lubrication function and the cooling function. But usually we have also a coolant to cool down the turbocharger. We need a cooling system because turbocharger can reach up to 1000 degrees C, especially the turbine side. Usually is made in cast iron, and the turbine wheel is made with special alloys, made by special alloys like titanium alloys or stuff like that, which have to resist high temperatures. While the compressor housing is usually made in aluminum, and the compressor wheels is also made in aluminum, which can be cast or a billet part, derived from a billet aluminum part, so CNC machine. Usually we have the wastegate, which is this valve. The wastegate is a bypass valve which is needed to protect the turbo from overboosting. So we have that outlet side of the compressor, we have a little channel which is connected to a solenoid, which is actuated when the engine control unit feels an overboost condition. So this solenoid delivers a certain amount of pressure to this valve, which actuates this shaft, which opens this valve, and we have that the exhaust gases, which normally enters the turbine and pass through the scroll and exit to the axially to the wheel, the flow is directly bypassed in this sense, so the turbine wheel can slow down in a way that the overboost condition is avoided. So this is a safety device. It's a device that wastes exhaust gases energy, but it's necessary to protect the turbocharger from possible damages. So, as I said in the beginning, the main purpose of a turbocharging system is to increase engine power output. Here on the board we can say that we have the brake power formula of an internal combustion engine, 4-stroke. The brake power formula, so the brake power output on an engine, is composed by all these terms, which are, very shortly, the organic efficiency, the indicated efficiency, the equivalence ratio, the fuel overheating value, corrected to the stoichiometric fuel ratio, the volumetric efficiency, which is the most important parameter, fuel-related parameters, efficiency-related parameters, geometric parameters, and operational parameters, target requirements from engine design. Volumetric efficiency is the main parameter related to the use of a turbocharging system, because it expresses the ability of an engine to force as air as possible, a matter of how much air we can deliver to the engine and how much air can stay within the engine from a geometrical standpoint. So, in naturally aspirated engines, this volumetric efficiency, it's not really an efficiency because it can be greater than one, even in naturally aspirated engines, because we can take advantage of particular phenomena like pressure waves, ram effects, and so on. But in turbocharged or supercharged engines, this volumetric efficiency is a bit different. So it is expressed as the ratio between the volumetric air mass flow rate over the manifold air density times engine displacement times the revving speed over 2. The manifold air density is a relative quantity, because in supercharged engines we have to refer to the density of the air which is in the manifold, and why we would like to have as air mass flow rate as possible, because if we have more air delivered to the cylinder, we can inject more fuel, increasing the engine output power. So these concepts are related inside this parameter, which enters in the brake power formula. Moreover, there are two ways to increase engine power. Increasing, for example, artificially with the turbocharging system, the air delivered to the engine, and decreasing engine displacement. So this is like the European way to increase power, or for example increasing engine displacement while keeping the volumetric efficiency at a lower level, for example using a naturally aspirated engine with high engine displacement. And this is typical of American engines. An example of a turbocharger mounted in this particular car, which is a Subaru WRX STI Type R. This is a JDM car, and it mounts a single scroll turbine. We can see that the turbine is placed with this orientation, because this is a boxer engine, so an horizontally opposed engine, where we have that here there is the intake system, Then under the intake we have the engine, and under the engine we have the exhaust manifold. Exhaust manifold exit from the engine and are connected and joined on this side on the turbine. So we can see here that this is the turbine side, this is the compressor side, and we have here we have the cooling channels. The compressor is connected silicone manifold which enters into intercooler. Because the boxer is a flat engine, we have more space on the top. Having a top mount intercooler and a turbocharger placed so closer to the intake system, we can reduce a lot the puff of the compressed air. So the air is compressed in the compressor, then is delivered to the intercooler, which cool down the charge, because when we compress the air, we increase the density, but we increase also the temperature. This particular car has a system which takes water from a tank and inject waters on the intercooler when we have a very high output power, so cooling the air delivered to the intake system.
And this is my dream car.